Hey, good morning, guys. How's it going? Yeah, we are in a highly volatile market. I had a couple of short setups like TTD and SC, but now they're gapping down, so they're ruined. Kind of funny how all these beaten down growth names bounce perfectly off the rising 50 monthly. Man, I should have grabbed my balls and just bought all of them. Matt? Yeah. Well, I don't know. Not my type of stuff. Is it me or is MarketSmith slow updating the earnings data? I'm not getting earnings data on several stocks like INMD. Man, these copper related tickers are just going crazy. Man, TTD is up 45% from the lows. I just couldn't buy a reversal candle. Oh well. Holy shit, FCX. Oh, I mean half size. And DDoG too, I only got filled half size on the opening range highs. Because there was probably like 1,000 people buying the opening range highs. You fucking schmucks. Guys, new chat rules. The cult leader buys first. And then you guys buy, okay? I'm gonna update the chat rules. This is not acceptable. The cult leader gets to buy first. I'm the worst alpha male ever. Fucking bullshit. Ha ha. I should just ban someone randomly to show my dominance. Is DCFC going to round trip on me? Stay tuned. Looks like momentum is broken for now. Yeah, UNG is the ultimate round trip. Had a nice nice little short squeeze, then it ran into the excessive highs at 1950 and now it's straight down. Guys, as traders, we have two jobs. We have to identify things that are gonna short squeeze, aka where to buy. And then we have to identify where they're gonna run into excessive highs, aka where to sell. That's the two jobs we guys have. Yes. Exactly. BRK.A? No, wait. BRK. Oh, BRKA, yeah. Yeah, 2000 is the normal number now. Snow. Oh, holy shit, this thing is strong. So we had all these big bounces. I kind of mistraded the bounce a little bit. I did. I just hesitated. I hesitated and then I kind of missed the train. But that's fine. You don't need to make money every single swing in the market. That's what Livermore taught us. You don't need to catch every minor fluctuation. Yeah, Bill, that EP worked out really well. Really, really well. That's right. That's how a good EP works. Now, I hesitate. Like, I wouldn't have traded this anyway. It was kind of thin. Or maybe I would have. But yeah, it would have been better if there was more of a base. And, you know, I'm not really comfortable with these types of EPs. We've seen a lot of them. They gap up into these declining moving averages. Then they kind of just fade off. But this one worked excellent. It may still fail though, right? Like you want a good EP, you know, you want this thing to go to 300 before the next earnings season. But is it gonna go there? I don't know. This is why I took T-Dog because, you know, it's clean air here, right? There's no declining moving averages. Nothing like that. All of the commodity names are just going nuts. Yeah, save EP worked well. Yeah, it did. Mm-hmm. Gosh, an ex up. I got stopped out 2 days ago. Now they're back up. Oh well. A lot of these beaten down tech and internet related stocks, they're up like 50% in the past 2 weeks. A lot of them are up like 50%. 40-50%. Thinking, and they're kind of, yeah, we'll see. See what happens to them. Well, missing the bounce, there were a lot of reversal setups. Like, you know, I talked about the monthly, the 50 monthly a lot, right? And the 20 monthly, and all of them kind of bounced off the 20 or the 50 monthly. And you had this, you know, net, you had this trend reversal on stuff like SC, you had a reversal candle, stuff like TTD, you had a big reversal candle here. Well, it's obviously it's easy in hindsight. That's the point. It's easy in hindsight. But you know, when you're sitting there real time, it's super difficult. You're kind of like, is it the bottom? It's just going to gap down the next day.
That's the thing.
TSM, man. This one looks interesting, so longer term play. But it's a good sign that we are kind of filling the gap down. That's a sign of strength for now. Financials are weak. Or actually not, they're not that weak. So everything energy, commodity related, and all the beaten down names are very, very strong. MOS. Beautiful. D-Dog getting to the average daily volume area already, that's good. DCFC, oh no volume on DCFC today. Yeah, they're all strong. All the cloud names are super strong. Yep. And now they're running into these moving averages. I don't know if it means anything, but I'm looking for, if you get strong closes and maybe a gap up or something tomorrow, I'm gonna watch some of these stocks with potential, you know, short-term shorts. See if we can get a little bit of a reversal to the downside. They're not there yet, but some of them are getting there. Could be some, yeah. Little bit of a high probability cash flow trade coming up, maybe. Well, beaten down. China names are starting to move a little bit. Man, these moves are violent. TTD up 50%. But still, there are not the type of setups I like are not really there yet. There have been some in the commodity related names over the past few weeks, but other than that, not many. Gotta be patient. Damn, this snap came all the way back. Oh well. Who uses Snapchat? Most people under 30. Exactly. Who uses Snapchat? People who have friends. That's true. I think. Bill up 74% from the lows 2 weeks ago. Big moves in these names. But that's what we want to see now. You know, something like Bill, for example. You know, if it kind of stops here, pulls back, goes sideways in the 230 area for a couple of weeks, build some range, let the 10 and 20 catch up, and you know, build some kind of a flag. That would be nice. Same thing with snow. Kind of goes sideways here for a few weeks and kind of tightens up, and then just straight up 40% in less than in 2 weeks. Wow. SQM. I really wanted to buy it, but it's just so thin. Super thin, and it wasn't worth it. I bought some ALB. What's ALB doing? Not as explosive, but still going the right way. It was kind of close stopping me out actually at near the open. If it had gone down another dollar, I would have gotten stopped out on this gap down. And this Mara too, man. I had it perfectly opening range highs, and then I kind of it closed weeks. I sold it just to be safe, and then it next day it kind of gapped down, went a bit lower, and now it's straight up. It's been tricky, tricky. A lot of shakeouts and TQQ too. Like I had it perfectly here, and then it had this little shakeout last week. Actually, I should have bought it here on the 60. Oh well. Actually, I should have bought SPXL because that one held up much better. Net. Oh yeah, what happened to PanW? Oh yeah, and FDNT from yesterday. They had like more of these traditional type of breakouts. But not for me. Twilio is another one. Just bounced perfectly off the 50 monthly. If you can reclaim the 50 day, heck, maybe it goes back to 300. Not. Yeah, MU is strong. That's one hell of a strong semiconductor name. I had it on the EP last time it had earnings. But then it kind of tanked because of the market. But now it's just just straight up. Straight up. At what point did you stop feeling the depression when you were trading, as you previously stated that you were slightly depressed? Yes, I was slightly depressed probably the first 4 or 5 years of my trading career. It's not until I started making like, I don't know, hundreds of thousands per year. Year after year that I just kind of felt like, you know what? I think I can do this. AFRM. I'm starting to slowly build a potential short watch list if these stocks keep going straight up. For the next few days. Could be a mean reversion trade coming up in some of these names. ShareVision would like to sponsor Colomaggi. No, thank you. Ah, oh, D-Dog. Oh. I hate you guys. You fuckers. Here's where everyone bought. Now it's gonna go to 250. With me having a little bit more than half of the shares I wanted. Thank you guys. I love you too. Wait, Vilio was at 263 in after hours? Oh. Alright. Alright, you down. NRGU, build a new flag. Yeah, I just hope it goes higher. Oh yeah, DCFC found some bidders again. Hopefully this thing doesn't round trip on me. I want it to go to 30. How much is it to ask for it to go to 30? If this thing can't go to 30, Biden has no juice. Yep, That's fresh from my thumb. That's correct. Airbnb is also very strong. Just needs to go sideways a few weeks, build this base, have a next leg up. Yeah, we're finally seeing a lot of these, and you can clearly see which ones are, you know, bouncing hard, which ones are not. Something like Square, you know, it's, you know, really beaten down, but it's not really bouncing. You see this? It's not bouncing. It's still below the 20. It can't even come up for air. Same thing with this Roku, kind of. Well, it's now it's kind of starting to bounce a little bit, but also, you know, enormously beaten down, but it can't bounce a lot. And then you have stuff like SC, right? Was a big, you know, beaten down, but it had a big bounce, 40%. TTD too was beaten down. It's, you know, over 50% now. Snow, this wasn't even that beaten down, and you know it's already big move from the lows. So you can clearly see the rotten eggs versus the tennis balls, or actually the fresh eggs, because rotten eggs they kind of float to the surface, so that's not a good analogy. Have I seen BTU? Yes, I have now. There was another one of these call names that had an EP range break. Was it Arch? No. ARLP maybe? No. CIX. It was CIX. Yeah, I had an EP, the earnings, you know, and this range break at the same time. Those are the best when you have a breakout EP of like a solid base. Yeah, it's straight up. Small account edge. I remember I looked at it on, you know, 2 days ago. Very thin for me. And now you have this BTU doing kind of similar thing. Oh yeah, what's the uranium names too? Yeah, CCG had an EP yesterday. Man, I should have bought it. All the commodity related names have had good follow through. You're upset about Mara? I get upset about mistakes, but Mara wasn't a mistake. I traded it perfectly. It just didn't work out. It would have shaken me out no matter what. Shit happens. That's the problem with a lot of these reversal names, like, you know, something like SC, right? I mean, like, how do you know this day is gonna be the bottom, right? Like, let's say you thought this was gonna be the bottom, right? This day here, you know, high volume green reversal candle, right? Oh, but it wasn't the bottom. And then you thought this green candle was gonna be the bottom, right? The reversal of the lows, but that wasn't the bottom either. How do you know this is gonna be the bottom, right? How do you know? How can you have any conviction in a setup like this? Right? Or something like TTD. Like, where do you start buying it on this day? Do you buy it at the close when it's already up 18% from the lows? Like how do you buy it? Do you buy it when it's still red on the day? This was actually one of my meaner version setups, but I was hoping for one more red day, but well, you know, they're difficult. Or, you know, same thing with Snowflake, right? Is this the bottom? Big reversal candle, undercuts the 200-day moving average, reclaims. Is this the bottom? Nope. Another big green reversal candle. Is this the bottom? Nope. Is this the bottom? Yes. How do you know? And yeah, you know, a lot of these you could have used like the monthly moving averages to a certain degree. Holy shit, TTD is relentless. I mean, if this thing closes strong, like has a gap up tomorrow, that's gonna be a top reversal type of a... Maybe, we'll see. It depends. There could be a couple of day mean reversion there, potentially. kind of funny how Lucid held up really well for a long time, and now it can't even bounce. D-dog, going straight up. Alright, I'm falling asleep here, guys. Thanks for joining and see you tomorrow.